On the Medical Watch for you this afternoon, bypassing a big incision in a bypass operation.
WGN medical reporter Dina Baer describes this less-invasive approach.
For many patients, the fear of open-heart surgery keeps them off the operating table. But doctors say coronary artery bypass is life-changing, and so is the lesser-known and less-invasive technique only a handful of surgeons offer.
Gary Retkiewicz knew he needed surgery to open up blocked arteries in his heart, but the active 67-year-old feared the long road to recovery.
My dad had gone through it 40 years ago, and I saw not how just how the surgery impacted him short term, but how it changed the rest of his life, and I didn't want to go through that.
A little research led him to Loyola.
This is Gary's main vessel, which supplies about 60% of the heart. And that has pretty solid 70-80% of stenosis.
Where he was offered what's called a small incision bypass, an alternative to the tried and true but more invasive open heart procedure.
When you go through that procedure, you also run the risk of infection. You can have wires pop through. The sternum can't heal properly. There's a chance of infection. And once I found Dr. Manjukia and his procedure, it minimized the risks.
A traditional coronary bypass operation requires a large cut through the sternum, the bone in the chest. During a small incision bypass, doctors access the heart from a 7 to 8 centimeter opening between the ribs.
It is going through the side of the chest. We don't break the sternum bone. We go in between the ribs. We don't break the ribs either. It's on the side here, about 7 to 8 centimeter sized.
Special instruments help doctors tunnel to the heart. Cameras guide the way.
We did not have this kind of instruments 10 years before. Now we have very fine, long-handled instruments, and we also have very sophisticated camera systems.
Gary took a shot at the unconventional surgery and quickly resumed his regular routine.
2 hours after the procedure, I walked in the hallways. The next morning at Loyola, the cardiac staff had me jogging in the hallway. The next morning, I walked up and down flights of stairs, and then on Monday morning, Dr. Manjukia said, we need to send you home because there's nothing wrong with you anymore.
I would say 80 to 90% of patients feel very good at day three, and some of them take a little bit longer, day four, day five, but it is still 3 to 4 days ahead of other standard operation, and they're able to move around much quicker than the standard sternotomy operation. Their recovery is way faster. They can go back to their work. They can start having their normal lifestyle within a week.
Knowing what people have gone through, you just feel incredibly blessed and fortunate to not have gone through the pain and suffering and to get back to a normal life in a very short amount of time.
Loyola doctors have performed 12 small incision bypass surgeries so far. There are some restrictions and limitations in terms of who qualifies for the procedure. There's more information on our website. Back to you.